Hey everyone, this is Amber from Baiguan. I am at Wuhan today, attending Baidu's Creator Conference. This is the annual conference for the developers, and there are new large language model launched and a lot of the new exciting features. And I thought I'd take this opportunity to try out their robotaxi. I actually wrote a newsletter last year about their robotaxi, but I have never got a chance to actually experience it. So today, since we are already in the city of Wuhan, I thought we'd take a try and just see how it's like to ride a robotaxi. So let's get started.
So now we're trying to get a robotaxi. This is an app which looks very similar to Didi or any other like Uber. The region in the blue area is the area where the robotaxi can go. Okay, so now if you just hit this button, 3 minutes. So
run.
The pickup spot is set to the place right across the street, which actually looks a bit scary because I have no idea where am I going to get on the taxi. It looks like a very busy traffic intersection. That's our car. Feels like it's stuck in the traffic. I really want to go there, but I'm not sure. Wow. Okay, here we go. We have successfully got a car. I don't know what is going to happen now. This is a very scenic view recommended by the local. What we're going to do is we're going to go through the city as well as the Long River. Oh wow, this is actually a bit scary, but the good thing is for the introverts, now we don't need to talk to the driver. Look at that. And also the car smells really nice. You know, it's very difficult to get a cab that actually smells nice, especially in this time of the year. It's super hot. Okay, so we are trying to make a turn. That's uncanny. Okay, so we are actually making a U-turn. Ooh. You can actually play music during the ride. So the total trip will be about 14 kilometers, which is going to take roughly 21 minutes. Oops. Oh wow, the brake actually feels very sudden. It looks like we are in the middle of a traffic jam, and Wuhan is actually one of those cities in China that is famous for the difficult traffic. I don't know if Baidu's robotaxi will be able to navigate this traffic, so this time let's just see how it's going to navigate. Okay. What are we in the mood for music? Guoyu hip hop. Let's tune in some Chinese hip hop. So what are we in the mood for? Why are all the music so sad? Okay, so let's do a top hit of 2024. I have not listened to a single song on this list. I must have become old. This is actually a bit scary, to be honest. We're entering a ramp. I believe this is one of the high-speed roads for the city. As you can see, the traffic, well, to be honest, if I were the driver, I would have to stay super focused. And what the robotaxi is doing is it actually tries to switch lanes. I think all the human drivers are being super tolerant to robo-taxi because, as you can see, we're strictly following the speed limit, which is not followed by many of the human drivers on this road. Look at that. I think it's somebody left the trash. This is getting a little bit scary because I'm not a Wuhan local, but I believe this is one of those high-speed roads for the city. And as you can see, the traffic here is like super busy. If I were a human driver driving on this road, I will have to stay super, super focused. And what Baidu's robo-taxi is trying to do is like switching lanes, going through the traffic. So this actually feels a little bit scary because you never anticipate what a human driver will do. And based on my understanding, Wuhan is one of those cities in China that is famous for the difficult and busy traffic. But of course, if you're from Wuhan and I had the wrong stereotypes, please do correct me. But I think the positive side of the story is that if the robotaxi can drive safely in Wuhan, it's probably going to be able to drive in any other place in China. If you take a look at that bridge, this is where we cross the Long River. Trip has 10 minutes left. And it shows the exact route that we're going on the navigation. And as you can see here, we are about to cross the Long River, and this is the longest river in China. Can I zoom in on this? Okay, apparently no. Let's just see what else. And a bunch of safety notice. Okay, let's see what else. Super cool. And this is also where you control the air conditioning. This bridge is one of the iconic view of the city of Wuhan. Look at that, that's another robo-taxi right in front of us. Hello, friend. Okay, let's see if we can get a shot of the Long River. Long River, right there. We're crossing the river. We are crossing the river. Right here, We are crossing the Long River. This is
the Long River, which actually makes me very nostalgic because in my hometown Nanjing, we also have a bridge like that. And that's because Long River also cuts through the city of Nanjing, just like Wuhan.
I have sweat in my palm because as you can see here, the traffic seems very busy. We're not riding the car in a special region set for the testing purpose only. So we are officially on the other side of the Long River, and there is 3 minutes left until we reach our destination. The traffic is less busy once we get to the other side of the river.
We're almost there.
So we are here. I don't know how I'm gonna pay for this, but I guess I need to get out of here. Should I roll out the window? Okay, cool. Okay, there we go. Okay, now I'm confused. Are we done? Okay, I guess we're done. Bye bye. So this is our destination. This is a riverside park on the other side of the Long River. And look at that bridge. I think that's where we came from just now. For some reason, this place actually reminds me of Dumbo in Brooklyn. That makes me very nostalgic. I love this place. So that's it for our entire ride. It was a 20-minute ride for about 14 kilometers. The total cost was 19 yuan, which is, I believe, less than $3. I think it's much cheaper even compared to other human drivers taxi operating in the same city. So I truly enjoyed the ride. I think it was such an incredible ride. It was super smooth, especially considering the fact that the traffic was very, very busy. I highly recommend it, although just during this process, I felt a bit nervous and scared at the beginning, but after all, I think super, super enjoyable ride, and bonus to the fact that I don't need to talk to the driver, and I highly recommend that if you get a chance to visit Wuhan, definitely try it out.